Today I'm joined by Jennifer Barth from ImmunoPrecise Antibodies. Jennifer, good to meet you. Thanks very much for your time.
Thank you, of course.
If you could tell us a little bit about ImmunoPrecise Antibodies and the focus here for you.
Sure, absolutely. So ImmunoPrecise Antibodies is a company that's brought forward a new way of solving a complex therapeutic antibody discovery for large pharma and biotech companies. And we do that in a couple of really unique ways. One is we bring very innovative technologies forward, all under one roof, all designed specifically for therapeutic antibody discovery and optimizing our clients' chances for success.
Right.
And doing that end-to-end, everything from the idea they bring us to having a product and all the information they need to do their pre-IND application.
Because I suppose it's... Is it too costly, too time sensitive for these companies to be doing this drug development work themselves these days?
Yeah.
Is that why they come to you?
Absolutely, good question. Most companies have actually undergone pretty significant restructuring to be able to outsource these programs because it is expensive, and then they lack flexibility if it's all in-house to be able to change gears or change the program and then have all the internal staff to run a diversity of different types of programs in-house.
So how many of these companies have you worked with?
Oh, we've worked with several hundred, easily over several hundred.
And is there a typical, in terms of time, is there a typical sales cycle here?
There is. For larger pharmaceutical clients coming in, for especially our higher revenue, more niche programs, the sales cycle is somewhere between 9 and 12 months. By the time we get through, yes, legal paperwork, they love to do due diligence, really, get in there and learn a lot about us.
Well, tell us, in terms of a bit more detail then, what makes you unique among some of the other drug developers, if you like?
Yeah, great question. From the very time a client brings us an idea, we not only lay that out in a very comprehensive way, but we're able to go through a very, very large repertoire of how to solve every problem from a custom perspective.
Mm.
So when we look at, what type of organism we're going to use to really develop the drug of interest, we don't really have any limitations. Most of our competition is extremely limited to a couple of different species of animals.
Right.
When it comes to how to immunize, we have double-digit ways of doing that, and we can customize that to really optimize the success for the program. When we discover new drugs, we have quite a few very, very innovative programs we can choose from. So we're not always pushing everything through a specific platform that is what we specialize in. We customize it, and we look at really broadening the opportunity for success. So, from that to the fact that we can take it everywhere downstream from there, characterizing, manufacturing, optimizing and engineering, to really make that the best drug product forward before it goes into humans, testing in animals for the efficacy of the drug, all of that, being able to do that end-to-end really is a unique perspective of what we bring forward.
So that's interesting. So you take these drugs up until the point of clinical human trials, do you?
Yes, so we drop them off really where the client is ready to apply for the pre-IND or EMA application in Europe. And we've really provided them with the information they need to apply for their patent, to apply for the use in humans. So where we leave off is the GMP or clinical grade manufacturing that typically would go to the next goal.
And from a revenue perspective, how does it work? Is it a fee for service? Do you partner up with these companies? Is it a mixture of both?
Yeah, it is a mixture of both.
Right.
Yes, it is a mixture of both. It's a fee for service. With a fee for service platform, we receive about 40 to 60% of the financing upfront. And then they pay on milestones after that. We do have some royalty generating aspects of what we do as well. And then we have several large pharma companies that really prefer the partnership model and to out-license at the end of the successful program. So.
Well, of course, there's always, when it comes to clinical trials, there's always that element of risk.
Mm-hmm.
With having these pharma companies pay an upfront fee, and should the drug not make it through the clinical trial, where does that lie for you?
Right. So we don't absorb any of the risk associated with the final product. If at some point during the program they say, this product doesn't really look like it's meeting our specifications, they could call the program off. All the initial money, of course, stays with us. But our success rates are well over 95%, so it's a very, very uncommon procedure.
Right.
So once they have the final product in hand, everything else is really up to the client. It's fairly well understood.
Well, I'd imagine there's an element of trust. when they come to you?
There is. Really, that's part of why that process of due diligence is so long, because we're developing a relationship with a client that's going to be ongoing, everyday touch points. They like to work really closely with our scientists. And so trust and really understanding, yes, exactly who they're going to be working with, that they deliver when they say they're going to deliver and what they say they're going to deliver is extremely important.
So what's going to be one of the big focuses for you this year? Is it securing, as you said at the start, some of those bigger ticket, higher margin deals, is it?
That is exactly it. For 2019, over the course of the last year, we've built such a strong foundation. Really looking at synergistic opportunities, cost and market synergies, and bringing together departments and teams, so we're acting globally. Our sales platform, our pitches, everything is now unified. Our name has really gotten out there well. It's turning heads. People know who we are, that we've arrived on the scene. So the calendar year of 2019 is just very, very aggressive sales, marketing, and business development, especially in the eastern part of the United States. Boston, Cambridge, we just opened up new offices there for BD and sales. So it's full steam ahead for 2019.
Very interesting, Jennifer. Yeah. Good to meet you. Thanks for your time.
Thank you, of course. Thanks for having me.